بين النور والظلماء شتان بين الرشد والإغواء شتان بين فتاة دين آمنت وفتاة دنيا في ربى الأهواء شتان بين النور والظلماء شتان بين الرشد والإغواء شتان بين فتاة دين آمنت وفتاة دنيا في ربى الأهواء لله در الحاملات أمانة الطامعات بجنة وجزاء الداعيات إلى الهدى في حكمة فلهم من الأعماق جل دعاء لله در الحاملات
صلى الله عليه وسلم إن شاء الله on behalf of the Aris Institute I welcome all of you for the first lecture today in Uloom al-Quran bi-idhnillah. And because we will speak about the Quran, in the beginning we must know the meaning of the Quran. What is the Quran? What is the meaning of the Quran? Of course, the Quran is the first book, the first book that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only book actually between our hands. And when we speak that we believe in Christian religion or Jewish religion or Suhuf Ibrahim or Suhuf Musa, we believe in them, but it's not our rules and regulations from the books of the Quran or the Bible or the Torah or Suhuf Ibrahim Musa. Whatever in our hand, that is our book, that is our ruling. That means the ruling of the prophets before Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is not our ruling, is not our book. We believe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed it. Yes, no doubt about that. But we don't follow it. We follow only the Quran, the one in our hand. And the Quran is one of the first of the names that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has revealed to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Qiyamah, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم, إِنَّ عَلَيْنَا جَمْعَهُ وَقُرْآنَهُ فَإِذَا قَرَأْنَاهُ فَاتَّبِعْ قُرْآنَهُ. See, إِنَّ عَلَيْنَا, subhanAllah, and even, you know, we're going to speak how the Qur'an was revealed to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam through 23 years. 23 years revealed to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, pieces and pieces and pieces. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the sign that that is a Qur'an, that means collected together. And the meaning of the Quran is very important to know, is continuous reading. The meaning of the Quran is continuous reading. You always recite it, you're always reading. And the source, the from the Arabic language, the source of the from the meaning of the Quran, al-qara, alif, lam, qa, ra, hamza. Alif, lam, qa, Ra Hamza Al-Qar. The meaning of Al-Qar, that means collection. Collection. And subhanAllah, in the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gathered also the other books in the Bible, the Torah, Suhuf Ibrahim, Suhuf Musa, it is there. Now I have a question for you, and I need an answer from you, inshallah, if you can give me the answer. What is the purpose that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent us the Quran, or sent us the prophets and the messengers? Why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent us the prophets and the messengers? Anybody can give me this answer, inshallah. Why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent us Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent us the Quran? That's true, but there is a purpose and reason for that. There is purpose and reason that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what is, okay, let me just the question, why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent us the prophet and the messenger? What is the reason? What is the purpose? Aisha.
Okay.
When you say Aisha as an example for us to follow the guidance, but still is not there. Is the purpose is Aisha is writing something. Yes, that is the answer for La ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah, that is the key, that is the answer. Exactly. Allah Azza wa Jalla says in the other surah, Surah Al-Dhariyat, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنْسِ إِلَّا what? إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. I created jinn and mankind for one duty. The duty is to worship me, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said. Alright, so another name of the Quran called Al-Furqan. Thank you. Another name of the Al-Furqan. The meaning of the Furqan, the one make a farq, the meaning making firq, that means divider. The one firq is divider. See, this firqa and this firqa. Firqa, that means this part and this part. You see that? Then here, the one he is making differentiation between the truth and the falsehood. The truth and the falsehood. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called the Quran in the Quran. In the Quran, in the Mus'haf, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called Al-Furqan. Yes, in Surah Al-Furqan. There is a surah called Al-Furqan. Exactly in ayah number one, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, تَبَارَكَ الَّذِي نَزَّلَ الْفُرْقَانَ عَلَىٰ عَبْدِهِ لِيَكُونَ لِلْعَالَمِينَ نَذِيرًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has revealed Al-Furqan, the one distinguished between the truth and the falsehood. Also, another name of the Quran. So we have two names so far for the Quran. Al-Quran and Al-Furqan. Then also Al-Dhikr. Al-Dhikr. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says Surah Al-Anbiya, وَهَذَا ذِكْرٌ مُبَارَكٌ أَنزَلْنَاهُ. I think is ayah number 50 in Surah Al-Anbiya. Surah Al-Anbiya. وَهَذَا ذِكْرٌ مُبَارَكٌ أَنزَلْنَاهُ. This is a dhikr. Mubarak is blessed. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has revealed it to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says also Surah Al-Shu'ara, وَإِنَّهُ لَتَنْزِيلٌ مِنْ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. Would that mean another name? Yes, another name is Tanzeel. Tanzeel. So Tanzeel and Dhikr we have, and Al-Furqan and the Quran. Four names so far. Can we add another name? Yes, Al-Kitab. The book, Surah Al-Imran, ayah number 3, نَزَّلَ عَلَيْكَ الْكِتَابَ بِالْحَقِّ مُصَدِّقًا لِمَا بَيْنَ يَدَيْهِ. نَزَّلَ عَلَيْكَ الْكِتَابَ بِالْحَقِّ مُصَدِّقًا لِمَا بَيْنَ يَدَيْهِ. So you have الكتاب, الذكر, التنزيل, الفرقان, and القرآن. So far, five names. Five names. Subhanallah Rabbil Alameen. Of course, those names and every name, there is a reason that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent it. But I want you always to remember something very important. Ayah number 9 in Surah Al-Hijr. Ayah number 9 in Surah Al-Hijr is a challenge. A challenge for whoever wants to change a dot. Dot in the Quran. A'udhu billahi min ash-shaytan ar-rajim. Inna نحن نزلنا الذكرى وإنا له لحافظون. Allah Azza wa Jalla says, we revealed the dhikr. We revealed the dhikr, the Quran, and we will protect it. Protected from anything. And some people, they try to change anything from the Quran, but they failed. They failed. See, and in the time of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, after he died sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, people try to, in fact, in the time of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, those people declaim they are prophets. They try to bring Quran from their own, of course, and believe it or not, they failed. And I read some of those people, what they revealed to the people, or they read to the people. It's so funny. So funny. Bismillah. Alhamdulillah. But the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has challenged the people of Quraysh to bring an ayah. An ayah, they failed to bring an ayah. Now, let's understand the mustalah, the Islamic term of the Quran. And please, we're going to go word by word to understand it, to comprehend it, to live with it. You know, yes, it is this course is the academic course and for the university, but you are a da'iya. You, as a student of knowledge, a da'iya, you give this da'wah to everyone. Then what is the exact meaning? Let me read, you know, say that in Arabic for you, and then translate the meaning and explain word by word for us to comprehend, to live with the Quran, to live with the Quran. And I mean it when I say to live with the Quran, as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when Aisha described the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, what she said, innahu kana Quran yamshi ala al-ard. He was a Quran walking on the surface of the earth. He was a Quran, memorizing the Quran. Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah ta'ala, when they put him in a prison, Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah ta'ala, قال, ماذا يريد أعدائي مني? What does my enemy want from me? See? And he said, and described the Quran, إن جنتي في صدري. جنتي? Yes, he said, the Jannah in my chest, in my heart. He described the Quran as Jannah. It's truly, you know, when you travel and you don't have even piece of the Quran in your hand and you start reciting Surah Al-Fatiha, whatever you memorize, Surah Al-Baqarah, this, and that's so unique. And you memorize it, and believe me, when you recite it, you always discover something. That's why the first term of the Quran, the meaning of the Quran, هو اللفظ العربي المعجز. هو, it is the pronunciation or the term of the Arabic term, miraculous, not miracle. Miracle, the pyramid is miracle. The China wall is miracle. It's the other thing, you know, they have miracle, people do the miracles. You know, that's my, but miraculous, only Rabbil Alameen. So again, because we're going to take it word by word, please, if you know how to write Arabic, write it down. If you cannot, you just write the meaning, inshallah. So with huwa lafz, it is lafz that means it is the pronunciation. Al-Arabi, Arabic term, al-mu'jiz, that means miraculous. Miraculous. Al-muha bihi ila Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, biwasitati Jibreel alayhi salam. The revealed to Muhammad, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, through Jibreel alayhi salam. So it is a miraculous Arabic term, miraculous, revealed to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with Jibreel alayhi salam. وهو المنقول بالتواتر. See, منقول بالتواتر, coming through 23 years. We're going to explain that in more details, inshallah. Al-maktub fi al-suhuf is written in the tablets, in the papers. It's written already. Every term is written. Not after 100 or 200 or 300 years they wrote the Quran. No, no. In the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that Jibreel came. So al-maktub fi al-suhuf is written in the pages. Al-muta'abbad bitilawatih. So you worship Allah when you read it. Al-muta'abbad, that means we worship Allah, bitilawati, that means when you read it. Al-mabdu' bi surat al-fatiha. You started with surat al-fatiha. Ends with surat al-nas. Now, honestly, this term, from many, many books, I collect all those terms together for you just to understand the word of the Quran. See, when I say the meaning in Arabic, first language in Arabic, we said continuous reading. That's it. From the word al-qara, from the word al-qara, that's the Arabic term. But the Islamic mustalah term, the mustalah, that means like Islamic term, al-Quran, huwa اللفظ العربي المعجز. And we say, what is معجز? اللفظ العربي المعجز. Quran هو معجزة. معجزة means miraculous for the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. That Allah عز وجل revealed to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. And the Arab, they failed to bring an ayah just like the Quran. And they know what is the Arabic language. They know what is the Arabic language. It's not something They didn't know. Yes, they know the people. That is their language. It's their language. But there is balagha. Balagha, it is words. No one can bring it. And like balagha in a word, I really cannot find define the balagha. It is so unique words. Even the Arab, they will be like shocked when they hear those kind of words together, balagha. And not only balagha. I try to get this term, inshallah, for you was balagha. Do you know what balagha is? Eloquent? No, more than eloquent, actually. It's stronger than eloquent. It's eloquent for, because anybody can be eloquent, you know, but that means ultimate eloquent, maybe? Something like this is more than eloquent, yes? Al-balagha, and speak about amba'il ghaib. Listen, speaking about the future. Future, yes, and speaking about the past. And that is the miracle. Thank you. And that is the miracle. Is speaking about the future and speaking about the past and things already happened. And not only that, there is ijaz ilmi, there is scientific terms. Scientific terms for the Quran, yes. The mountains, the babies, the oceans, yeah. And not only that, and huwa Tashri'a muhkam. This means legislations and thank you. The legislation, and no one understands this legislations. No one can bring just similar to this legislations or rules. Daqiq, accurate, good for every time, in the past, in the present time, in the future. Subhanallah, Rabbi, I mean, that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Isra. I will repeat what I just said, inshallah. I will repeat it after that. Try to type that, inshallah. Say, Allah Azza wa Jalla says in Surah Al-Isra, ayah number 88, A'udhu billahi min ash-shaytan rajim. Qul la'in ijtama'at al-insu wal-jinnu ala ayya'tu bimithli hadha al-Qur'an la ya'tuna bimithlih walau kana ba'duhum liba'din zahira. Allahu Akbar. See, Allah says, Ya Muhammad, tell them, لو اجتمعت الإنس والجن of all human beings and all jinn gathering together to bring similar to this Quran, they will fail to bring similar to this. Even if they are working together day and night, ظهيرة, that's me working together. Subhanallah. And not only that, Allah Azza wa Jalla says in Hud, this ayah, I just recited ayah 88 from Al-Isra, but in Surah Hud, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala challenged them to bring 10 ayat. Surah Hud number 13. قُلْ فَأْتُوا بِعَشْرِ سُوَرٍ مِثْلِهِ مُفْتَرَيَاتِ. Say, bring 10 surahs. 10 surahs it bring from that Quran, see, and it's still is a fabrication. It's fabrication. So subhanallah Rabbil Alameen, and they failed. Allah Azza wa Jalla, because they challenged the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with the Quran and the Quran and the Quran. عَمَّ يَتَسَاءَلُونَ عَنِ النَّبَأِ الْعَظِيمِ الَّذِي هُمْ فِيهِ مُخْتَلِفِينَ. What are we talking about? And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said in Surah Al-Baqarah, number 23, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَإِن كُنْتُمْ فِي رَيْبٍ مِمَّا نَزَّلْنَا عَلَى عَبْدِنَا فَأْتُوا بِسُورَةٍ مِنْ مِثْلِهِ وَادْعُوا شُهَدَاءَكُمْ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ إِن كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ. See, if you fail 10 surah, okay, bring one surah. It's still, they failed to bring one surah. And those people, the people of the Arab, they know the Arabic language. They know what is good and bad in the Arabic language. It's not a joke. Let me repeat what's mu'jiz again in fast. You see, it's a miraculous came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Words and statements. Quran. Al-Quran huwa mu'jizat al-Rasul. It is the miraculous for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the Arab failed to bring similar to this, I'm just explaining the word mu'jiz or miraculous. The Arab, they failed to bring similar to this Quran, and They are the people of the Arabic language, the grammar of Arabic language. They know the Arabic language, but good and bad. But miraculous, Ahl al-Balagha, they are the people, they are eloquent. They know what's good and bad. And not only that, the Quran brought with the miraculous. The history, the news for the past nations, the past nation, and the present and the future. And the future. And what is in the Quran, scientific miracles, we're just discovering this. Just discovering this. And the Sharia, the rules and regulations, is very accurate for every time. Good, this for every time. In the past, in present time, in the future, these legislations and these rules. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he challenged the people of the Arab, for all kind of Arab, not even Quraysh, all the Arabian Peninsula, they know Arabic language, even from people from Yemen. The people from Yemen, by the way, they are the genuine Arab. The people of Yemen, they are the genuine Arab. Believe me, those people, when they came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they become Muslims immediately. Why? Because they know they are the genuine Arabic language. You know, Prophet Ismail alayhi salam, those people, they learn, they taught Prophet Ismail alayhi salam the word when they migrated from Yemen all the way to Arabia, when Sad Ma'rib, the dam of Ma'rib, demolished and destroyed, and they migrate, they came, a group of them, they came to Arabia, or the area of Mecca. And they start to teach Ismail alayhi salam the language. So those people, they know the Arabic language, and the faster people become Muslims. No argument. They listen to the Quran. Oh, that makes sense. We know the Arabic language. We know what is bad and what is good. Yeah, subhanAllah. Alhamdulillah. So I believe, you know, we are in those people that try to fabricate some stories and some movies about the Islam, about the Quran, about the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. When they ask this idiot, one from Florida, that he called himself priest, and when they ask him, did you read the Quran? I said, no, I will never read the Quran. Exactly, because you are dumb. That's why you cannot understand. You do want to read the Quran, just like Abu Lahab. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed, tabbat yada abi lahabin wa tab, ما أغنى عنه ماله وما كسب سيصلى نارا ذات لهب وامرأته حمالة الحطب في جيدها. الله عز وجل it challenged Abu Lahab and his wife in the hellfire, and they told Abu Lahab, just say you are Muslim, lie, just lie and say you are Muslim, you then this ayah, this surah is not going to be true. And he said no. He said no. Imagine that, subhanAllah. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, just a challenge. Abu Lahab, he knows the Arabic language. The surah revealed to Abu Lahab and his wife, and they are in his fire. They told him, you know what? Just say, I'm Muslim, and just like act, you are Muslim, just to make the people believe this ayah or this surah is not true. And he refused. See how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala challenged with this Quran? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala challenged. And if you read those ayat again, when you have time, the ayah number 88 from Surah Al-Isra, قُلْ إِنْ اجْتَمَعَتِ الْإِنْسُ وَالْجِنُّ عَلَىٰ أَنْ يَأْتُوا بِمِثْلِ هَذَا الْقُرْآنِ لَا يَأْتُونَ بِمِثْلِهِ لَا يَأْتُونَ. They will never ever bring the jinn and ins gather together to bring just like this Quran. There is no way they will fail. وَلَوْ كَانَ بَعْضُهُمْ لِبَعْضٍ ظَهِيرًا. Even they work together day and night, they will fail. Ayah number 13, Surah Hud, قُلْ فَأْتُوا بِعَشْرِ سُورٍ مِثْلِهِ مُفْتَرَيَاتِ. Bring 10 surah if you can. They failed. All right. Bring one surah. Ayah number 23, Surah Al-Baqarah. وَإِنْ كُنْتُمْ فِي رَيْبٍ مِمَّا نَزَّلْنَا عَلَىٰ عَبَدِنَا فَأْتُوا بِسُورَةٍ مِنْ مِثْلِهِ وَادْعُوا شُهَدَاءَكُمْ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ إِنْ كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ. See, bring one surah and bring everybody. No, they failed. Is that mu'jiz or not mu'jiz? Is that mu'jiz? Of course it's mu'jiz. It's a miraculous. Miraculous from whom? Because it is from Allah. Because it's from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let those people speaking about the Prophet, about the Quran, about this. In fact, when they speak about the Prophet, we love the Prophet more and more and more, and we love him more than we love our own selves. We love the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam more than anything in life. He's our life. He's the one I just mentioned. So you just saying the one he brought us from the darkness to the light by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is miraculous. Let's come to the other meaning now. Al-muha bih is revealed to. Revealed to whom? By the wording to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Muhammad ibn Abdullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam through Angel Jibra'il alayhi salam. And this is the job of Angel of Jibra'il alayhi salam. To bring the message to the prophets and the messengers. And guess what? And then now his job finished. He's in heaven. Now he come only once every year to the earth. Do you know what day he come to the earth? Only once. Only one day, one time, one day he come to the earth. Do you know what? Which one? Which day? Anybody? Very good, Aisha. Laylatul Qadr. Laylatul Qadr, he come, Jibreel alayhi salam, to the earth. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Shu'ara. Surah Al-Shu'ara. By the way, do you know the surah the, in ayat, the longest surah in the Quran? The longest surah in the Quran is Surah Al-Baqarah in ayat, right? What is the second longest surah? Anybody can tell me what is the in ayat, the numbers of ayat, the longest surah after Al-Baqarah? After Surah Al-Baqarah and Ayat, which one the longest surah after Al-Baqarah and Ayat? No one typing anything. Ibrahim? No. Not Al-Imran. In Ayat, not Al-Imran. Okay, anybody see Sister Janifa Islam? Oh, the surah gonna recite right now, Surah Al-Shu'ara. Surah Al-Shu'ara, that the longest ayat in after Surah Al-Baqarah. All right, the ayah, what is now, let's go back to our subject. This is not our topic, this is our topic. Al-Muha bihi, revealed to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to Muhammad ibn Abdullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam al-Qurashay, is through Jibreel alayhi salam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Shu'ara, from ayah number 192 to 195, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. وَإِنَّهُ لَتَنْزِيلُ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ نزل به الروح الأمين على قلبك لتكون من المنذرين بلسان عربي مبين. الله عز وجل says إنه لتنزيل رب العالمين is revealed from رب العالمين. رب is Allah سبحانه وتعالى. He revealed the Quran. رب العالمين from the Lord of jinn and human being. نزل به الروح الأمين. That means جبرائيل عليه السلام. His name is الروح الأمين. جبرائيل عليه السلام. على قلبك in your heart. Oh Muhammad, he revealed it in your heart. لتكون من المنذرين. To mean warning the people. Warn the people. What there is a Jannah and there is a hellfire. بلسان عربي مبين. In a clear Arabic language. A clear Arabic language. And Surah Al-Najm. Surah Al-Najm. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said the surah in ayah number 4. إِنَّهُ هُوَ إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا وَحْيٌ يُوحَى إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا وَحْيٌ يُوحَى. It is revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And that is very important, and as we're telling us that Allah azza wa jal brought this to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Alright, now الوحي, we speak about وحي. What is the meaning of وحي or revelation or reveal? really, let's understand it in order to understand the term, the Islamic term. In Arabic language, وَحَيْتُ إِلَيْهِ وَأَوْحَيْدَثْ mean I revealed to him, I whispered to him, I spoke with him secretly, only me and him. Does it mean أَوْحَيْتُ إِلَيْهِ وَأَوْحَى رَبُّكَ إِلَى النَّحْلِ, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to the bees. وَأَوْحَيْنَا إِلَىٰ أُمُّ مُوسَىٰ, we revealed to the mother of Musa عليه السلام. This kind of revelation that in the heart, that means Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put in our heart to speak up. And also the wahi, والوحي الإشارة, the sign, in Arabic language, the sign, the fast sign, call it إشارة. Then that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed not only to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but Allah azza wa jalla revealed to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam what? Al-Quran, the word, the statements. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to the other, we're going to just speak about like Surah An-Nahl, ayah number 68, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَأَوْحَى رَبُّكَ إِلَى النَّحْلِ وَأَوْحَى رَبُّكَ إِلَى النَّحْلِ أَنِ اتَّخِذِي مِنَ الْجِبَالِ بِيُوتًا وَمِنَ الشَّجَرِ وَمِمَّا يَعْرُشُونَ. وَاللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ revealed to the bees to take from the mountains and the trees homes and houses. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to Imam Musa, Surah Al-Qasas, number 7, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَأَوْحَيْنَا إِلَىٰ أُمِّ مُوسَىٰ أَنْ أَرْضِعِيهِ. So we revealed to the mother of Musa breastfeed him, but not through Jibreel alayhi salam. No, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to her exactly. Al-wahi, saying this kind of wahi, ilham fitri, that means natural revelation. But for the bees is just like fitra. So ilham gharizi or like a fitra. But for Umm Musa, just like I feel it. I am a human being, I feel that. I can feel that. But for the bees, if you have the bees, take the bees, the queen of the bees, and some bees in some area, they will do the same thing over and over and over. The ants, same thing. It's just like they have some kind of systematic nature. And that is the revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But al-ilham al-fitri, the revelation of fitra of Musa, okay, feed him, and then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then فَإِذَا خِفْتِ عَلَيْهِ, if you are afraid or worry about him, have him in a box and put your son and let him go in the ocean. But no one woman will do something like this to her baby unless it is from kind of peace and tranquility from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, just like the way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to the mother of Musa alayhi salam. And also shayateen, by the way, Surah Al-An'am 121, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaking about the food and those people not eating slaughtered food and mentioned the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And subhanallah, this is the shaytan Allah azza wa jalla, ayah number 121, part of the ayah 121, وَإِنَّ الشَّيَاطِينَ لَا يُوحُونَ إِلَىٰ أَوْلِيَائِهِمْ لِيُجَادِلُوكُمْ. The shayateen still, they revealed whispering, here the whispering to the people, to some certain people, to argue with you. So how many times the issue of food in America and Europe and this area, say halal, haram, slaughter, mention the name of Allah, not mention the name of Allah, shaytan make us like argue about this. That means the shaytan, the revelation is not revelation, it's a waswasa. Waswasa means whispering. And normally make the evil good. The mission of the shaytan, make the evil good, bismillah. All right? That is the revelation, the word revelation. And also, إشارة السريعة من رمز, رمز that means signs. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives signs sometimes to the prophets, but they know it is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Just like Zakariya alayhi salam, for example, in Surah Maryam, number 11, ayah number 11, فَخَرَجَ عَلَىٰ قَوْمِهِ مِنَ الْمِحْرَابِ. فأوحى إليهم أن سبحوه بكرة وعشية. And they say he get out of the mihrab or the where is he worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Zakariya, and he told the people to make tasbih, make a sign, like a sign language, make tasbih for the people to praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, glorifying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bukratan wa ashiya in the morning and in the night time as well. Alright, so that's all. But also, وما يلقيه الله إلى ملائكة من أمر ليفعله. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to the angels. Allah Azza wa Jalla revealed to the angels. Not together, all the angels together, you do this, you do this. No, no, Allah revealed to the angels. Like Allah Azza wa Jalla mentioned in Surah Al-Anfal 126. وما يلقيه إلى الملائكة إذ يوحي ربك إلى الملائكة إذ يوحي ربك إلى الملائكة. Allah Azza wa Jalla revealed to the angel. أني معكم فثبتوا الذين آمنوا. I am with you and give strength and power to the believers. To the believers. So that means that is the wahi in Arabic language. The meaning of the wahi in Arabic language. But شرعاً Islamic term الأنبياء فقط إعلام الله سبحانه وتعالى لنبي من أنبياء بحكم شرعي ونحو. Say that mean the meaning of Islamic term for wahi. That the revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to one of his prophets. Revelate what? So, like a hukum, like Islamic ruling or a story or something that some Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed, but most likely a ruling. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to one of his prophets, hukum, I mean one of the rules of rules or anything like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to the prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Right, that is the meaning of wahi. Of course, alhamdulillah. We have many types of wahi. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Shura 51, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم وما كان لبشر أن يكلمه الله إلا وحيا أو من وراء حجاب أو يرسل رسولا فيوحي بإذنه ما يشاء إنه علي حكيم. Please give me attention to this because it's a really important ayah to know what is the types of wahi, the kind, the types of wahi. Say Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never sit in front of the prophet of the messenger and speak with him like man to man, astaghfirullah al-azim. No, it's not. Even when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went to from Mi'raj to Sidrat al-Muntaha, he's not standing before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yes, he's Allah before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not a person, astaghfirullah, saying laysa kamithli shay. Nothing resembling like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Say that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Ash-Shura, ayah number 51, وَمَا كَانَ لِبَشَرٍ أَن يُكَلِّمُهُ اللَّهُ. Say there is no human being that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will speak to him face to face. Astaghfirullah al-Azim. Illa wahyan, except in the revelation to the heart, of course. Aw min wara'i hijab, just like the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Mi'raj where Sidrat al-Muntaha, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has spoken to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So the hadith Aisha say, kadaba man qala anna Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ra'a Allah. So there, whoever said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he saw Allah in the day of Mi'raj, he's lying because he did not see him. Is that that is a divider between Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he made divider. Hijab doesn't mean divider. Aw yursila rasulan, or send an angel. Send an angel. Fayuhi bi'idni. Rasulan fayuhiya ilayhi bi'idni. Then he will reveal to him by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ما يشاء إنه علي حكيم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the highest and the one have the wisdom. Alright, so it's very important to know the difference between to speak face to face to one like Musa alayhi salam when he went to Sinai and he take the order from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's not Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's not a person, astaghfirullah al-azim, standing before Musa and he takes. No, Allah revealed to Musa alayhi salam. He spoke with him, Kareem Allah spoke with him, but not they spoke with him person to person, but is revelation or a divider or a messenger like wahi. like the wahi from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فالوحي number one, القاء المعنى في القلب is number one. What is that? We speak about the type of the wahi. Number one, it's very important to know that means Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to the heart, put in the heart. And that was the hadith of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, إن روح القدس نفث في روعي. That means the روح القدس, that means Jibreel alayhi salam, he put in my heart. In my heart, what is in my heart? What is the ayat of the Quran, from the Quran, or revelation that means in the battle of Badr, for example, what should do this and do this and do this, that means direction. That is in the heart. Number one, in the heart. All right? Number two, al-kalam min wara'i hijab. There is a divider, like Sidrat al-Muntaha, or the Musa alayhi salam, when he went to Shatt al-Gharbi in Sinai, and he take the order from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned in Surah Al-Qasas, ayah number 30. It is in Qur'an, فَلَمَّا أَتَاهَا نُودِيَ مِنْ شَاطِي الْوَادِ الْأَيْمَنِ فِي الْبُقْعَةِ الْمُبَارَكَةِ مِنَ الشَّجَرَةِ أَنَّ أي موسى إني أنا الله رب العالمين. Say Allah سبحانه وتعالى called موسى عليه السلام in the area where is البقعة المباركة, that means the blessed area in Sinai where there's certain tree over there. And then in that area موسى he reached that area. Then he heard Allah سبحانه وتعالى speaking to him and say أنا الله. Say I am God. I am Allah سبحانه وتعالى رب العالمين. And he gave the revelation to Prophet Musa alayhi salam. This is number two. Number three, what is my yulqihi malak al-wahi al-mursal? That means a messenger or an angel come in a format of angel. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he saw angel in his real picture, by the way, twice. But he come in a form of a man, in the form of man, and he come to him and he start and they start to speak with him face to face, and the revelation that Allah Azza wa Jalla, as I mentioned to you in Surah Al-Shu'ara 193, say نزل به الروح الأمين, revealed in the الروح الأمين is Ibrahim عليه السلام على قلبك لتكون من المنذرين, he revealed it to your heart with the Arabic language. Okay, so this is the type of the wahi, three types of the wahi. In summary, of course, there are some books speaking about more than that, a lot more than that. All right. when we're speaking about how he came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam with the hadith Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu ta'ala anhu. عبد الله بن مسعود رضي الله تعالى عنه قال لقد رأى من آيات ربه الكبرى the ayah that means Allah سبحانه وتعالى جبرائيل عليه السلام he came to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم in real picture and that in سورة النجم لقد رأى من آيات ربه الكبرى قال رأى جبريل ابن مسعود he said the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم the ayah number 18 سورة النجم ayah number 18 سورة النجم لقد رأى من آيات ربه الكبرى he saw جبريل in the real picture. He saw Jibreel in the real picture. قال رأى جبريل في صورته له 600 جناح. He had 600 wings. 600 wings. وطارد أن يظهر في صورة إنسان. And he come in a form of a human being. إنسان. And the حديث جبريل قال صحيح البخاري المسلم حديث جبريل when the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم he was sitting and a man with the he wearing shadida bayad al-thiyab, have very white clothes and very black or dark hair. You know the hadith Jibreel alayhi salam, and he started to speak to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in what is Islam, what is al-Iman, what is al-Ihsan, and the sign of the day of judgment. You know the hadith that he came in the surah of man, no one know him. And he sometimes come in the surah in a picture of man. In the picture of man, also like Dahya al-Kalbi. Dahya al-Kalbi, one of the great of the Sahaba. And he is very handsome man. Very handsome man in his format. In his format, Jibreel alayhi salam used to come to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And And sometimes he comes Jibreel alayhi salam, but the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not see him, like when somebody with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, like Aisha was with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and Fatima when he was dying, and many times Aisha radiallahu anha, she was with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam become like shaking and sweating, and sometimes hearing a voice like a bell, a strong bell. And when there is someone with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam the ayat or the ruling, what should do and so on. All right. So, and this is the worst things with the revelation, when you come like the bell, strong bell, like ringing and bell, strong bell came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And they can see the Sahaba, they can see that, by the way, in the face of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when you're getting very sweat, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, very tired after reveal that. And sometimes it comes just like the bees, or the nahl, the bees and buzzing, yeah, exactly, buzzing just like the bees came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, so, okay. And so on. I don't want to go in details because I know you know these things, and we discussed it last semester, alhamdulillah. But it's good to know it, inshallah. It's good to know it. Of course, a lot of people, I'm not going to speak about that. They deny that. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Surah Yusuf, some people will come and they will deny that. Surah Yusuf, by the way, revealed to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam together, or the whole surah revealed to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And with those people, if they just look at the miracles and scientific miracles in the Quran, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Fussilat, ayah number 53, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم, سنريهم آياتنا في الآفاق وفي أنفسهم حتى يتبين لهم أنه الحق. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, we will show them in the Quran آياتنا في الآفاق, in the universe, miracle in the universe, and in their own selves, for them to distinguish what is that truth or not truth. So how is the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you know, the origin of the earth, of the clouds, or the universe, the stars, and the positions of the stars, and what did the stars contain, and all this. So that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us in Surah Fussilat, ayah number 53, سَنُرِيهِمْ آيَاتِنَا, we will show them our miracles, our signs, فِي الْآفَاقِ, in the universe, and in their own selves. Look how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala create my mouth to speak for 1 hour, and my eyes to look at the camera for, and you looking at the camera and seeing me, and that is not normal. It's no human being can create this kind of mouth speaking like this, or this eye, and the miracles of the eyes and the brain, and how you comprehend that. Is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say to them, we will show you the miracles in yourself, in the universe, and yourself, to distinguish what is right and what is wrong. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ayah number 3 and 4 in Surah Al-Najm, وَمَا يَنْطِقُ عَنِ الْهَوَى, he never speak by his own desire. إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا وَحْيُ يُوحَى, it is revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let's go back now to the meaning of the Quran. We still speak about what is المتعبد بتلاوته. We say المتعبد بتلاوته, worship Allah when we reciting that. This Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that in Surah Al-Muzzammil, ayah number 20. عَلِمَ أَنْ لَمْ تُحْصُوهُ فَتَابَ عَلَيْهُ فَقْرَأُوا مَا تَيَسَّرَ مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, he know some people, they cannot memorize the whole entire Quran. Some people, they cannot comprehend the whole entire Quran. Then Allah will forgive you. It's not something, is obligation to memorize the whole entire Quran. فَقْرَأُوا مَا تَيَسَّرَ, read whatever you can from the Quran. That's it. يعني متعبد, see, you are متعبد بتلاوته, you worship Allah when you recite, you worship Allah, you recite the ayat, you recite the Quran, you be closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And every letter, you take hasana. To 10 hasana, every letter 10 hasana, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala multiply it more and more and more. ألف لام ميم is 30 حسنة. ألف لام ميم 30 حسنة. Imagine that. For example, in the صلاة, it's the last صلاة لمن لم يقرأ بفاتحة الكتاب. There is no صلاة will be accepted without reciting, if you pray by yourself, not in جماعة, if you, without reciting سورة الفاتحة. That is تعبد. That you're worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the word المتعبد بتلاوته, to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when you recited, that means every ayah, every letter in the Quran, you will be closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You recite alif lam mim with 30 hasana. ذلك كتاب ولا ريب فيك إبري ذلك ذا اللام كاف يقول الثيري حسنة and so on. So that is the word, the meaning المتعبد بتلاوة سورة الفاتحة in إبري صلاة 17 in only in فريضة 17 times a day you read سورة الفاتحة. And of course that in individual, but in جماعة the فاتحة of the imam is your فاتحة, but in some opinion, but still some opinions you have to read it. But Allah أعلم, you don't have to, you know, if you miss it, like if the imam in ruku', if the imam in ruku' and you make ruku', that's considered rak'ah for you. There is no fatiha here. But some is different on opinion, but there is no salah without reciting surah al-fatiha. Now, what is the meaning al-manqul bil-tawatur? We received it in tawatur, in pieces and pieces and pieces, and we collected together. We collected together. Say through 23 years, اقرأ بسم ربك الذي خلق خلق الإنسان من عرق. All the way to the last ayah in the Quran. We're going to say, speak about last ayah in the Quran. The اليوم أكملت لكم دينكم وأتممت عليكم نعمتي. This one or the other. But we're going to speak about it during this semester, inshallah, رب العالمين. That in, we'll say متواتر. Saying they come in pieces to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he ordered certain sahaba, that in the sahabi, to write the Quran in pieces and kept it by the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But Allah azza wa jal could protect it. And I mentioned this ayah, Surah Al-Hijr. I want to always remember that ayah number 9, Surah Al-Hijr. Inna nahnu nazzalna al-dhikra wa inna lahu lahafidhu. We revealed the dhikr, we revealed the Quran, and we will protect the Quran. We will protect the Quran, inshallah. I'll stop here. I will stop here, inshallah. And then if you have any question, any explanation, anything, can take it. And we'll take a break. And then we'll go back to the seerah. بين النور والظلماء شتان بين الرشد والإغواء شتان بين فتاة دين آمنت وفتاة دنيا في ربى الأهواء شتان بين النور والظلماء شتان بين الرشد والإغواء شتان بين فتاة دين آمنت